is pure theater.
Honorio has been pretty active this fight. I mean, he's not being reckless, but, you know, Eric's being a little more methodical. I think that
this fight brought to you by Tune Talk, and there's a tuneful little left jab from Eric Kelly that started off that round. And again, no sign that Banario is struggling for cardio. Early in the fourth. Could be all a bit of a misnomer, the fact that he struggled so badly to cut weight. He's not fading by now. He'll probably be okay. Both fighters dripping perspiration onto the canvas. Oh, good exchange. Left hand from Kelly.
Kick right to the liver.
Kelly.
Got
a finger in the eye there.
No, I think
that... Yuji Shibata has stopped the fight.
It looks like Eric's bleeding from the eye.
Yes, he is bleeding underneath the eye. It looked to me as if Kelly was complaining about a finger in the eye. Very rare that a fighter would take a legitimate punch and then cave in like that, because he waved stoppage, didn't he? Kelly was indicating, I don't want the fight to continue, but I think what he was looking at was a timeout.
Yeah, I don't know that he was giving up. I think that he got poked in the eye and that Yuji Shimada just didn't hop in there to stop it. You know, we'd have to take a look at that again in a replay here in a second, but he got cut underneath it. Let's see if we take a look at this here from the top. It's gonna be hard to tell.
Looked like a close fist.
Yeah, that looked like a close. He might have just got cut under the eye. It's really hard to tell. I don't know why. You know, until the referee stops the fight, though, Honorio can get in there and do whatever he wants to Eric. So we take a look at this from another angle. Let's see. It might have been a thumb in the eye. You know, guys like Randy Couture and a few people have been poked with that thumb, even though your fist is closed. I'd like to be able to ask Eric what happened.
Clearly, though, there's a bad cut under the eye. Let's take another look. A pretty confusing end to that one. Kelly, it seems there, is saying, wait, stop. That's what I'm getting from his body language there. And Yuji Shimada, in the absence of seeing any finger in the eye, understandably stopped the
call. Ladies and gentlemen, referee Yuji Shimada calls a halt to this battle at 1:01 of round number 4 for your winner by way of technical knockout and your new 1FC Featherweight World Champion. It's The Rock, Honorio Banario!
And we'll see if Jason can get some sort of an explanation from both fighters, particularly Eric Kelly, about how he interpreted the end of that. But we have a new crown champion, Honorio Banario, the 1FC Featherweight King. Improves his record to 8-1. 1FC CEO and founder Victor Kui will be putting that belt around his waist. The man who struggled so severely to cut weight comes out of this one with a stoppage victory.
All right, ready?
Fernandes
ready?
Ahead, still anyone's contest though. The touch of gloves before the final 5 minutes, and again, a lot of energy exhibited from McLaren, who makes a fast start to this final stanza.
The condition of this kid is exceptional.
He drives Fernandes into the cage.
Look at the balance of Fernandes. That takedown has worked on every single opponent McLaren has had. Now the damage a little bit more on McLaren's face. I think he might have took another low blow there, but he shook it off to stay right in the mix.
Our first contest.
Keep the momentum on his side.
Excuse me, Mitch. Our first contest that's gone into the fifth round tonight could well be our D88.com fight of the night. As I said earlier, it could be up there for fight of the year. The way that this one has turned around. Still Fernandes slightly ahead according to Rich, but McLaren has brought himself back into this contest after not quite being in it in the first 10 minutes.
I don't think the judges will be swayed by, you know, this display of just antics that he's displaying here, or he's just kind of showcasing here.
It's a crowd pleaser.
It's definitely getting the crowd on his side, but it's also, he also kind of got in the head of Bibiano a little bit, as just almost as much as that his fist did.
I think it might have done, you're right.
But McLaren is putting so much promise behind these punches. He's definitely improved in this, in the striking game.
But this is also where the tremendous experience that Bibiano Fernandes has will serve him very, very well. He's been in wars, he's been in roller coaster rides. He knows how to bring himself under control, last the full 25 minutes, and get the best out of it.
Consistently pushing forward, Bibiano is trying to control the cage in the distance, but McLaren's just doing a good job of staying light on his feet, picking apart his punches, and really ripping out that jab there.
What tremendous condition McLaren is in. With less than 3 minutes to go in this fight, he is still bobbing around.
Oh, that overhand right sets up beautifully, closes the distance well with it, and is able to get into that takedown. Now he's got the legs. McLaren's doing the right thing. Look at how wide that base is. Bibiano's gonna have to transition into something. I don't know if he can suck the legs out from under McLaren.
McLaren needs to have the better of the exchanges in this round in order to edge himself ahead if we're going by Rich's scorecard. The fight judged in its entirety, not round by round. The judges will have this one pretty close. More damage on Fernandes' face. It's been a problem since early in the third round.
McLaren very active, and that right hand was landed beautifully on the chin of Bibiano.
A couple of good
punches got
through.
He set it up really well. Fainting with a jab, and look at the way he's switching stances
from him. And in the southpaw stance, that's his biggest punch. It was a bit of a slapping punch, but it landed cleanly. Bit of an arm punch rather than full body weight and shoulder moving forward. But at this stage, certainly point scoring.
Inside leg kick landed by Bibiano.
Good work
from
the hands. McLaren pulling off a nice 1-2 there as he came off the cage wall.
Nice body kick landed by Bibiano.
Gets one back, not quite as powerful from McLaren. The overhand right from Fernandes, who's still stalking his opponent. He's doing the chasing.
He circles out really well, so Bibiano wasn't able to press him up against the cage. He spun around, utilizing the cage very well.
Great appreciation from this crowd at the Mall of Asia Arena. A full house, and we're into the final 45 seconds.
Both fighters are trying to leave everything in the middle of that cage.
Who can leave their mark on this contest in the most indelible way? Fernandes.
Good takedown defense by Reece McLaren, and also to exit with some punches.
They both quicken up the action. Inside the final half minute, the crowd on their feet behind me. Applause and cheers ringing around this arena. Final 20 seconds, the kick to the head from McLaren. What has Fernandes got left? Can McLaren pull out anything that will capture the judge's eye? A couple of spinning back fists. He looks up to the giant screen and sees that he's inside the final 10 seconds. Fernandes throwing everything he has as the seconds tick away. His championship belt on the line, and it will go down to the three judges at cage side after an absolutely thrilling contest here in Manila. taking a look at the replay.
Let's go
with
back
Mitch
in
Shelton.
Time and take a look at that body kick landed by Bibiano. Just this fight was an amazing battle of attrition. There's that left hand coming over from Reece. Bibiano answers with a shot of his own. McLaren, this is how the fight ended, just throwing everything they had at each other. What a tremendous fight for the bantamweight strap.
Before we go to the judge's decision, let's get the thoughts of Rich Franklin.
These guys are making my job so hard tonight, let me tell you. Listen, it was a close fight even at the end with the stand-up war. I think I would actually edge that stand-up war out to Bibby a little bit. But the lead that he had from the ground control earlier in the fight, in my opinion, gives Bibiano this fight.
All right, quite clear from Rich Franklin that Bibiano has edged it and, in his opinion, has probably been in front for the entire contest. But Reece McLaren, who is currently doing push-ups in the cage and doing laps of the cage, has made this a thrilling contest and is very much in the conversation. Three minds will apply themselves to who has won this contest, and those are the only minds that matter. McLaren's arm is in the hands of Olivier Cost. Bibiano Fernandes will come over in a moment. CEO of ONE Championship, Victor Cui, is in the cage. He gives McLaren a pat on the shoulder for a job extremely well done. I'm waiting for Dominic Lau to get in the cage. Clearly, there are judges' score sheets to be compiled, taken together. What a thrilling contest this is. D88.com fight of the night. Has to be, doesn't it? Keep in mind, we still have Brandon Vera and Hideki Sakine to come. In steps Dominic Lau. We're about to find out where the destination of this championship belt is.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds of battle, we turn now to our judges' scorecards. Judge number one calls his fight in favor of the red corner. Judge number two calls his fight in favor for the blue corner. And judge number three calls his fight in favor of your winner and still one bantamweight world champion, Bibiano the Flash Fernandes!
By split decision, Bibiano Fernandes retains his title, but without question, that was the toughest defense he had to make. Rematch, anyone? Reece McLaren has had an absolutely thrilling night, and the fans here at the Mall of Asia Arena in Manila have really appreciated his effort, shaking his head as he comes down the steps and leaves the cage. But that was an absolute thriller. Representatives from Brazil congratulating Bibiano Fernandes, who kisses his wife and still has that championship belt around his waist. What a performance from the champion.
Control the position, not use too much strength. Nice guard recovery by Aung La off his back. Double butterfly hooks here. Now a single butterfly. And Ngalani tries to drop the elbow. Aung La N Sang looking to control the body posture.
No sweat there. Steve, Michael, listen to this crowd. Got the body lock staying nice and tight. The shoulders, they because of the shorts.
Most famous personality in Myanmar.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coast, put a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 31 seconds in the first round. For your winner, by way of guillotine choke, Aung La N Sang!
Aung La N Sang, the Burmese python, wrapped the python around the neck of Ngalani and tapped him out in stunning fashion. Just sent the entire nation into a frenzy.
Li Kai Wen bounds out of his corner in southpaw stance, the orthodox stance on Rodion Menchevez.
Menchevez has got to use the jab.
Keep oh, the big combo!
Disappointed, and Li Kai Wen captures a huge win here in Macau.
That might be one of the fastest wins in one championship history. It was, in a word, extraordinary.
Look at this, sets it up, attacks in, and then just comes over the top with a beautiful right hand. Lands it once, and boom, finds a home for it on the second one.
A 10-second knockout, maybe contender for GoDaddy knockout of the night. It'll be hard to beat Li Kai Wen. 10 seconds, it all it took for the utter demolition of Rodion Menchevez. Let's go to Dominic Lau, make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the medal for this match, we have Mr. Zhao Jie, Studio City VIP. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kemp Chen, has put a stop to this contest after 10 seconds in the first round. For your winner, by way of knockout, Li Kai Wen.
Soaking up the goodwill being showered upon him, showing respect to his injured opponent. And Li Kai Wen takes the winner's medal back to China with him. Amazing performance, 10 seconds. Can you believe it?